Greetings, dear friends, and welcome to the Blue Cube YouTube channel. In continuation of the animation tutorial with Adobe Animate software, in this video, you will learn about the transform, align, and arrange panels. To access the transform window, we go to the window menu, and here I select the transform panel. If you press Ctrl and T, the transform window will be activated for you and placed here. In order for these options to be activated, I first need to create a shape like this. Then, with the transform tool, I select my shape, and now the options of the transform panel become active. Using these options, I can make my shape horizontally larger or smaller. I can also vertically resize my shape very precisely. If I want to proportionally resize my shape, here I click on this chain icon to activate it. Now, if you hold down the left mouse button and drag on any of these boxes, you'll see that your shape becomes proportionally smaller or larger. Again, I deactivate the chain, and I can individually resize my shape horizontally or vertically smaller or larger. Now, if I see that the new shape I created is not suitable and I want it to return to the previous state, I click on the reset option to revert the shape to its previous state. The next option is rotate. When I hold down the left mouse button on it and drag, I can rotate the shape to any degree I want. For example, I can rotate the shape exactly 45 degrees like this. Again, if we want to return to the previous settings, here I click on the option, and the shape returns to its previous state. The next option is skew. If I click here, its options become active. If I hold down the left mouse button here and drag, you'll see that the shape changes like this. Or from here, I can skew the shape vertically. This option can help us in designing and creating various animations. All right, I press Ctrl and Z to return the shape to its previous state, or I can click on this option to reset the settings to their initial state. Two options, 3D rotation and 3D center point, also exist here, but they are currently inactive. To activate these options, first, I need to select the shape with the free transform tool. Then, right-click on the shape and click on the convert to symbol option and press OK. Now you see that these options have been activated. If I change the 3D rotation option in the X-axis, the shape rotates in 3D. If I rotate it in the Y-axis, you'll see that the shape rotates in the Y-axis. We can also do the same thing in the Z-axis. And very precisely, for example, I can determine that a 20% rotation should be applied to the shape. You see that a 20% rotation is applied to the shape in the Z-axis. Again, I reset it. The next option is 3D center point. If I change the numbers here, no changes will be applied. To use this option, we need to select the 3D translation tool. You see, here the 3D center point is displayed, and we can change its position from here. I change its position in both the X and Y axes. Now, rotation is applied from this point. I can apply rotation from this part in the X-axis or from the Y-axis in the same way. I can place the 3D center point anywhere I want and apply rotation from there. I place it here again, and this time rotation is applied from this point. All right, I click on this option to revert the settings to the previous state. Quickly, I create another shape and select a part of my shape, change its color to make it more distinctive. Again, I select it with the free transform tool. Here also are the options flip selection horizontally and flip selection vertically. If I click on flip selection horizontally, you'll see that my shape is flipped like this, and now the blue part is on the left. If I click again, it returns to its previous state. The same happens vertically. To make it clear, again with the free transform tool, I select this part of the shape and change its color. Again, I select my shape and click on flip selection vertically. you'll see that the green part moves to the bottom, and we can flip our shape like this. The option Duplicate is also here. I click on it to create a copy of the shape. And in this way, I can have a copy of my shape. Again, I click on it to create another copy. So, in the Transform panel, we can do all the things I mentioned. We use this panel in animation. Okay, I press Ctrl and A to select all shapes and press the Delete key. For now, I close the Transform panel. I create a few ellipses and change their colors. I create another copy of the shape and select it. I hold down the Alt button and drag to make a copy and change its color again. I make this ellipse much smaller. One important point I want you to know is that if you select one shape with the free transform tool and place it on another shape, and I click here to deselect it and then select my shape again and move it, now you see that a cut is created in the previous shape. But to prevent this from happening, you need to convert each shape you create into an object. I press Ctrl and Z to revert to the previous state. I select it and click on the Create Object option here. I select this shape too and click on Create Object. And I select this shape and click on Create Object. Now each of my shapes has been converted into a separate object. If I place them on top of each other again, and deselect the shape and now separate the shapes, no cut is created on the shape. This point is very important. The next window is Align, which I want to teach you about. Click on Align in the Window menu. In this part, you can see it. I hold down the left click and drag it out so you can see this window more clearly. I'll place it here for now. In normal mode, if I select all shapes and click on the Align Horizontal Center option, it will align the centers of the shapes in one line. Now, if I click on the Align Vertical Center option, you'll see that all shapes are aligned on top of each other. In fact, the central version of all shapes aligns on top of each other. So, in the normal mode, we can align the shapes like this. But again, I separate the shapes and click on the Align to Stage option. In fact, the stage is the document itself, which is white. I select one shape and activate this option. Now, I can specify that the selected shape is placed in the center of my document, and I can easily place it exactly in the center of my scene. I can specify whether it should be placed on the left or right side or at the top. In this way, we choose the appropriate location for the shape. So, if you click on this option, it determines the position of the shape based on the scene or document, and if you disable this option and then select both shapes, we can adjust the position of the shapes relative to each other. Again, I press Ctrl and Z. The next option in this window is Distribute. If I enable Align to Stage and click on this option, the shape will be placed at the top, or I can place it in the center or at the bottom of the scene. In this way, we can also use this option. The next option is Match Size, which allows us to match the sizes of shapes. If I disable Align to Stage and select all shapes, I can match the width of all shapes. I click on this option, and the width of all shapes becomes equal. I can also specify that their height should be equal. I press Ctrl and Z. If I want my shapes to be completely equal in size, I click on the Match Width and Height option. In this way, all my shapes become equal in size. Now, if I have different shapes and want to equalize the spacing between them, I use this option, and in this way, the spacing between all my shapes becomes equal. I repeat this process to learn its application. Now, if I select only one shape and enable Align to Stage and click on the Match Size option, you'll see that the selected shape matches the size of the document. Okay, I press Ctrl and Z to revert to the previous size. I close the Align window so that you have fully learned it. I enlarge these shapes a bit. I select the red shape. Sometimes it's necessary to move a shape under other shapes. To do this, first select the desired shape, right-click on the shape. Now choose Arrange and then click on Send Backward. In this way, the selected shape moves one step backward. I press Ctrl and Z to return the shape to its previous state. Again, I right-click on the shape and this time select Send to Back. In this way, the selected shape is moved behind all other shapes in the document. I right-click again, and this time I choose Bring to Front. Now, the shape is in front of all other shapes. I press Ctrl and Z. If I want the shape to come forward only one step, I click on the Bring Forward option. This way, the shape moves forward only one step. So, using the Arrange option, you can adjust the arrangement of shapes. Also, in the Modify menu and Transform options, you can find the options related to Arrange here as well. Also, right-click on any shape. Transform and Align options are available here, and you can find each of these options here. In the Transform section, there are options related to the Transform window, and I have taught you all these things. Thank you for staying with me until the end of this video. Remember, if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, click the subscribe button or the subscribe below the video, and please like the video. Goodbye for now.